of the weekend here between the Portland State University Vikings and the University of Idaho Vandals. Welcome to the 2017 NPHC Conference Tournament presented by Barrelhouse Pub and Pizza. My name is Tyler Pisani, joined at the table today by Gary Allen. And Gary, you get some sleep last night?
Yeah, I did. But I was looking forward to today. I think this game should be good, and I'm really looking forward to the title game.
Well, these two teams both coming up just a little bit short yesterday as the Vandals lost the first game by a final score of 6-4. To the Western Washington University Vikings. That was the first game of the tournament, the number one seed versus the number four seed. And Eastern Washington, the host team, beating Portland State University yesterday, last night, by a sound 9-1. Portland State looking to come out today and avenge that big loss. Idaho making a change in goal. Logan Warren, number 35. He is the netminder for the Vandals.
It'll be interesting, Tyler, to see how Idaho plays this. If they played like they did against Western, Portland State's going to have their hands full because Idaho looked really good last night.
Well, and a little bit of a change up to the starting lineup. A big block there by Nick Alberts. He did very well last night. A lot of people saying... he was very good in net, something that we saw as well. Fundamentally good in net, Alberts was. But if the University of Idaho was here, they saw that he's a little weak on the five hole.
Yes, that's where they took advantage of him, with no question about it.
And a big hit on the far side of the ice, as that was Eric Miller. He's somebody that we watched yesterday get a little bit physical. Pass up the ice, a deflection right at the blue line and into the chest of Logan Warren. 6'5", 235 pounds from Salmon, Idaho. A new goaltender in net tonight.
And that's an interesting switch by Idaho because Grover played so well last night. It's interesting that they made a goalie change because he had just stood on his head.
Yeah, he had a ton of saves last night, and this game probably a little bit more physical than what Idaho saw yesterday, as Western is more of a finesse team. We talked about that a little bit. And now on the rush, kicked ahead by Peach. He's got it. He's got a man out front. Turning is Hicks, and he just can't find the handle. But we talked about that last night, that Portland State and Idaho and a goal. Oh, they're going to wave that off. They're going to say the goal was knocked off of its line before Hicks was able to get that in.
They're going to have to get together and talk about that because from my angle, it looked like the puck went in and the goalie moved it out, but they're saying no goal.
That's interesting.
And he's going to hold right now. The referee's talked to Idaho's coach, it looks like. Nope.
No, he's going to the scorer's table. He's going to...
It's interesting.
Yeah, because that felt like it was in before the net was knocked loose.
And Hicks did a nice job of coming behind the net and going short side on it.
Good heads-up play there by the Vandals. Lots of shots early on here. Less than 2 minutes in, each team already two shots. Portland State changing up their uniforms today, hoping for a better outcome. Going with the, we'll call them candy cane uniforms. A black and white striping on the overall green jerseys. They're going to move from right to left. University of Idaho moving left to right in the gold uniforms. And we see Merrill out here, the official. He did two of the games yesterday. It's nice to see that at least in some way the officiating will be relatively consistent through three quarters of the games. And Alberts loses his footing. Net knocked off again. And the referee is going to blow that one dead.
Had a little stick work at the end there to, for Portland State, letting Idaho know they didn't appreciate standing in front of the goal. But it's interesting, I'm just watching Idaho right now for the last 3 minutes. They look like they're picking up where they left off. They're attacking real strong, moving the puck really well. Portland State, it looked like they're doing what they did yesterday. They just haven't quite figured out which way they want to play, and that could be because they're a short bench.
Yeah, only 10 players today on the bench. They traveled with 11, I believe, but Noah Dolan to Jack.
Now you can start seeing every time there's a whistle, Portland State's getting more physical around the net, doing the extra little shove.
And that's something we saw last night a little bit too, but Noah Dolinajek, he didn't travel, or he didn't play with the team. I believe that he did travel. So Portland State, even short, one more player than what they thought. Good clearance down the ice as we do have a penalty. Tanner Ward, he's in the box 2 minutes.
And that was that little extra stick work he did in front of the net. That looked like the referee caught it.
And last night, the two games, as much as they were consistent with the same officials, or same official, they were called very differently. One of them was, they let them play a little bit more. And in the second, or in the first game, it was called more to the book.
And hopefully today, the officials just let them play, because this is for all the marbles right now.
And a good stick save there by Nick Alberts. Some pushing and shoving behind the net. And this is going to be the storyline of this contest. Both of these teams like to get physical. And neither one of them with a huge bench today as far as numbers go. And here comes Mirko Dragonic. Neither team with a huge bench. So it's going to be interesting to see how the penalties and the physicality, you know, turn the tables in this one. Back with it now is Moan. He's still got it. He puts it right out front. A tip, a shot, and a save by Nick Alberts. A good redirection by Ryan Schur right out front.
Again, even though the score was 9-1 last night, Alberts played a good game, and he's doing a nice job today. He's picked up where he left off last night, even though the score didn't indicate it. Another even strength right now, so we'll see what Idaho will do. They're definitely putting the pressure on Portland State. It was a big bump.
And now with it driving right to the net, a shot, kind of a floater there by Jason Smith, the captain, and snatched out of the air by Logan Warren.
Well, right now it's been a pretty good flow to the game. Sorry about the interruption, Tyler, but it's really actually kind of an evenly matched game, and we'll see if it continues with this.
And Idaho, again, coming out strong like they did yesterday. Something we saw against Western was that they came out ready to play here in this first period. And Portland State was a little bit slower to start. Tonight, both teams seem like they're going. And a good takeaway right in the neutral zone by Bear. He lost the puck, though, not able to take advantage of the potential breakaway opportunity. And now with it is Dragonic. And that's a turnover in the neutral zone by Moan. He's going to push it ahead to Sewell.
Nice hit by Miller. He's picking up from where he left off last night. He hit everything that moved.
And you're right. It does look like he's going to continue that. Pushing up the near side now is Sewell. Pass just too strong for him. Barnes has it. He's going to put it back into the neutral zone, right to the stick of Mraz. And now a good move by Ward. He's tripped up by Peach. That's going to be a penalty. Puck out to Warren. And Peach heading to the box. Now each team will now have a shot at the power play. Idaho not able to score on their first, but did have a couple of good opportunities. And now 5 minutes and 43 seconds into the first period. Idaho's going to get their chance. Or I'm sorry, Portland State's going to get their chance as Peach is going to sit 2 minutes for tripping.
There's some good movement by Portland State on this power play right now. They're cycling really well.
A shot and a save there. And that's something that they weren't able to do last night. Barnes a shot, stopped by Alberts. When they were on the power play, and maybe it was just Eastern Washington getting underneath their skin, but their first two power plays, they didn't register a single shot on net. And there is their first one on this power play already with 1:38 to go. That one just off of the toes of Alberts. Kept in, and now back to Barnes. Barnes looks to take a shot but doesn't make it to the net, and it's cleared all the way down the ice. And this is something we saw quite a bit last night from Alberts, is he's not afraid to come out of his goal and get that puck, which is something that his team's going to need so that they're not skating the full length of the ice each time.
Yeah, he's definitely not shy of getting out of the crease. He'll definitely come out to the top of the circle if he has to.
Some heavy pressure by Idaho there. Very aggressive on the penalty kill, forcing the icing with 1:02 to go in this Peach penalty. 2 minutes for tripping, 13:18 to go here in the first period of our third place game between the University of Idaho Vandals and the Portland State University Vikings, the number 4 and number 3 seeds coming into this tournament respectively.
Right now you can tell they're pretty evenly matched on both ways.
Ward taking it to length of the ice. He's got a man on the far side. That's Hay. Hay shoots, and Albert's able to get from, I'm sorry, Warren able to get from one side of his crease to the other.
Maybe they shifted goalies because right now Warren's playing a really solid net for Idaho. And so they may be equal on that because he's playing a good game.
And he takes up quite a bit more net than Nick Grover does. He's got 6 inches and just about 100 pounds. Shot just too tall by Portland State. But he's got about 100 pounds on Grover.
Well, he moves well laterally, so the 100 pounds doesn't affect him. He has some quick reflexes.
And a turnover there. Bear has it. He looks for the toe drag. Alberts loses his stick. But good defense there by Portland State. And now coming the other way. Good defense on the other side of the ice by Idaho. And a breakaway opportunity here for Hay. He's got to get around one more man.
There was some nice recognition by Barnes to get the goalie Alberts' stick back. He didn't skip a beat on that one, so it wasn't going to be effective either way they looked at it. There's another old school hip check given out. It's a lost art, Tyler. It's a lost art.
It very much is. And a broken stick there. Some anger on the bench of Portland State by Seth Starr. Or I'm sorry, that's Tanner Ward. Broke his stick over the bench gate as he was coming back on. I don't know if it was broken already. And he just finished the job, or if he was very unhappy with something that happened out there. Peach takes a shot right into the skates of a Portland State player right out front. And Idaho loses it into the neutral zone. Now back across his own line goes Peach. That's going to go far side to Murdoch. And now Johnson, he tries to feed it out front. He's got Hicks there. Kenning picks it up. Johnson now trying to get it to Hicks at the top of the crease, but he can't get it there. Hicks now out front. A one time opportunity by Kenning. And now Johnson has it. He tried to pull it back away from Mraz, but Mraz sends it to the far wall. And now Peach with a slap shot off of the shin of a Portland State defenseman.
I was talking about yesterday. Peach has one good game. He's a solid defenseman, but he's not afraid to go up on the rush either. He has a nice game. Very talented player. As you can see, as he has the puck right now for Idaho, just heads up player.
And Hicks has it knocked away. Portland State now having a hard time getting the puck out of their own end. Idaho very aggressive here on offense. Across the crease and a good chance by Idaho as Ryan Schur had a one-time opportunity. And Hicks raises his hands again thinking that he had another goal. But they're going to wave that one off as the net was dislodged.
One thing I've noticed, Albers is having a lot of trouble holding on to the stick. He lost it again on that shot by Hicks. But right now, if you look at the shots on goal, Idaho's just putting a lot of more pressure on Portland State right now, especially on the offensive zone.
And again, Portland State with the short bench, this could be in their favor, only having to play in one zone, as long as they can keep the puck out of the back of the net. Not having to skate up and down the ice could be beneficial to them in the long run. But it's going to be tough on Alberts if he has to face this many shots all night.
That was an excellent save by Alberts. He had that the whole way.
Already 13 saves on the night for Nick Alberts.
And Pierce walked in right on top of him, and Alberts held his ground really well.
With it is Schur. Schur is going to go back to Watney. Watney winds up, fires a shot, blockered away by Alberts.
That was a laser. He had everything on that shot. Right now, it's an interesting flow to the game. Both teams are still, in essence, trying to fill each other out, although Idaho is seeming to put more pressure on the offensive zone than Portland State is right now.
Shot wide of the mark. That's going to go to the far side to Miller. He backhands it out front, and now Portland State a chance with an odd man rush. That one knocked off of the stick of Mraz. And now Starr with it. And back now to their own blue line, Portland State. That is Ward that has it. He has it taken away by Schur. Schur's got a man out front. He gives it to Watney. Watney looks to take a shot. And good defense there by Seth Starr. So he gets just enough of that to send it up and into the netting.
And Starr is another player for Portland State. I like his game. He's a real heady player. Doesn't get out of position much. Definitely likes to use the physicality of his skill level. But he's a good hockey player. He's been impressive.
This time it goes back up to the point to Murdoch. Now with it is Sewell. Sewell's going to bring it out front. Fires a shot. Knocked away. This time a swing and a miss. And now they're going to head back the other direction. Jumping over player sticks. I believe that's Starr. No, in fact, that's Barnes. And he's still got it. He's got a man out front. He's going to take a shot. Deflected right down to Davis, but Davis couldn't get there. And now a two-on-one opportunity for Idaho, not able to control the puck. Peach has it atop the logo at center ice, and now in the corner is Dragonick.
Warren did a nice job of tracking that puck on that one shot from Portland State.
And now that is Barnes. He's going to give that right back to Warren, who's now going to leave it off to his own man, Murdoch. Some pushing and shoving, and coming away with it is the Vandals. Hicks puts it ahead. They're going to say high stick, but doesn't matter because it's Murdoch all alone. I'm sorry, that's not Murdoch. That's Keel Kenning. And a tie-up at the blue line as that was Peach and Ward kind of ran into each other, both turning and skating for the puck.
Kenny did a nice job of toe dragging on that for the Vandals. But again, Alberts is on top of it. That was a nice move by him in the top of the zone. Right now, pretty evenly matched played game.
Yeah, definitely more even than what we saw in the first period of either game yesterday. Alberts again coming out of his net. Dangerous, though, as he gives the puck right to Liam Johnson. Had he been a couple steps more forward, he may have had a chance at an open net. With it again is Kenning. Kenning makes one man miss, gets it to the center, fires a shot wide of the mark. Picking it up is Kenning. Kenning goes down. Johnson picks it up. Johnson circles back. Gets it to Kenning behind the net. Waiting for him up top is Moan. But it goes all the way back to Miller, who just barely keeps it in. Johnson now on the far side. Picking it up is Smith. Jason. Kenning now. He's got to fight for it. And he knocks Starr off of the puck, and they're going to call that a penalty. We'll see what they call here. A couple of Portland State players on top of their own goaltender, and they're going to say Kenning was the culprit.
And with this conversation, I don't think he's disagreeing with what the referee called there. It's interesting watching Albert, because he does take a lot of gambles out there out of his crease, but as a player, you got to know Portland State has to like that because he's helped them on a couple rushes by coming out. But that one time he almost coughed it up. But that does help the defenseman a lot if the goalie's going to be active.
And we'll see if that pays off for them or if it comes back to haunt them. But that two-minute penalty, a roughing minor for Keel Kenning.
And right
13-14 into this period.
Right there, Warren tracked that all the way in the slot. And Sampson had that. One timed it. Nice stop by Warren.
Now a good face-off win for the Vikings. Picking it up is Barnes. He's going to feed it down low to Ward on the far side. He's got a man. He takes a shot. And again, Warren doing a good job going post to post.
He's playing extremely well right now. I'm very impressed with it. Actually, I'm impressed with both goalies from the Vandals. Both of them are equally as good.
And now we're going to go to the far side. It's going to be Pierce versus Starr. And Pierce winning that face-off battle for the Vandals. Vikings still with possession, though, in the attacking zone with the man advantage right out front. And no chance there. Back with it is Hay. He's going to feed it down low to Barnes. And the Vandals able to clear it as Miller sends it the length of the ice. And again, there we see Alberts out of his net, playing with it a little bit. And feeding it all the way up to the blue line to Meraz, even though he had man in his face. Ward has it to Meraz. Meraz looking for the rebound off of the wall. Ward has it. Tries to send it across the crease. But his man in the wrong position.
See, that's what I was talking about earlier. Alberts came out and took a gamble, but they got a nice rush off of that basically zone pass by Alberts. He did a nice job.
And now we'll see that pushed ahead through the neutral zone. That's going to go near side just over the stick of David Davis. And here come the Vandals again. Sure has it. He takes a shot, bounces right to the stick, or what would have been the stick of Thomas Bear had it been on the ice. And now with it is Davis. He's going to put in a shot from the blue line. Peach behind his own net. And pushes it around one man. And now he still has it. Going to send it the length of the ice with 33 seconds left on the power play. 5:17 left in this first period of the third place game of this 2017 NPHC Conference Tournament presented by Barrelhouse Pub and Pizza. Portland State coming across the blue line, and Murdoch with it. Sent back down the length of the ice, and Alberts again, like you were talking about, out of his net, slowing it down for his own man.
He's so nonchalant, too. If you watch how he's doing it, it's kind of like it's okay, his old hat for him. He doesn't panic at all with it.
And Smith trying to keep it in. It's nice for the goaltender to come out like that because as the players are skating towards them, he can kind of give them an indication as to what kind of pressure is coming from behind. Kenning takes a shot there from the far side. He's got Hicks out front. He's also got Peach out front. Gives it to Peach. Peach a swing and a miss. Just a little bit too tall with the little bit of it he got. Murdoch from the far side point right in front of the Portland State bench. And Alberts will hold on to that with 4:18 left in this first period.
That's one thing with Alberts I've been.
Well, he likes to get those assists, I'm sure. Something many goalies don't pay attention to is that assist category on the stat sheet. But some of them are just like players. They like to see their name there as well. And a good rush there by the Vandals. He's got a man out front and Starr. Starr can't get his stick to it. A good offensive opportunity there for the Vikings. Hicks now put into the boards by Barnes. Back to five-a-side hockey. That one's put right out front. Johnson can't handle it. Portland State right into the center, but can't get it out of their zone. Hicks, he's going to go to the far side to Kenning. Kenning puts a shot on net. Warren uses his blocker. I'm sorry, Albert uses his blocker. Back out into the neutral zone. Watney has it on the far side. And a good interception there in the center of the zone. A shot by Jason Smith, the captain. And
Miller's
going to
go off, it looks like.
And they're going to call that a trip. They're going to say Smith wasn't clear of him, so no penalty shot. But Portland State going to get a man advantage again.
I'll tell you one player, Miller, who just went in the box. But for his size, he moves extremely well. I've been impressed with him from yesterday and today, and he has a rifle shot.
This penalty coming 16:56 of the first period. Miller, two for tripping. And you're right, he's a big guy that can hit and shoot.
Well, he's definitely a physical player. There's no question about that. It's in his arsenal.
Well, at 6'3", 215 pounds, he's not a guy that I want to get in between him and the boards.
And he looks bigger than 215.
These are preseason weights. We'll call them that. We didn't make these guys hop on scales before the tournament, although maybe we should next
but
year.
But I'll tell you, he does move well for being so big.
Picking it up now in his own zone is Ward. He's going to go across one faceoff dot, turn, face the ice, and feed it ahead to his own man, Hay. Hay's got a man in the center of the neutral zone who feeds it now down a little lower back to Meraz. Meraz to Barnes, and Barnes has it taken away. Watney has an opportunity here all alone with Alberts. Watney, forehand, backhand, forehand, and Alberts a good poke check as he gets that away from Watney, and Watney now taking out his frustration in the corner on Smith, and that's going to get him a penalty. And he's still jawing at Smith. Watney and Smith here at center ice, pushing and shoving. Watney already knows he has a penalty, so he's looking to draw another one, but a 6-on-4 opportunity here for just a moment as Alberts is back in the bench. And finally, Idaho able to get a stick to that puck.
Watney definitely was looking at it. He was trying to take someone else out since he knew he was going in the box. He was trying hard to aggravate Portland State to fall for it and take a penalty with him, but none of them did. Even though there was a lot of chirping going on, and I think it was Smith that he was chirping with.
Yes, and Watney taking out a little bit of his frustration on missing that breakaway on the Portland State captain, but the Vikings going to have a 5-on-3 opportunity here with 39 seconds remaining on Miller's tripping minor. 1:53 left in the period. Watney likely to be sitting for the rest of the period with it now as Star. Star is going to give it to his assistant captain Ward, who almost trips over the puck. Far side shot held on to by Alberts. A good powerful shot by Connor Hay.
Well, I know one thing. They're going to have to get some people in front of Warren, because if he sees a shot from the blue line there, he's going to stop that 9 out of 10 times. They're going to have to start flooding the net and screening him.
Now on the far side, a big hit by, that was Schur on Hay. The Vandals wisely dumping the puck down the ice with 10 seconds remaining on Miller's tripping minor, going to give them a 5-on-4 disadvantage here as Portland State's not in a huge hurry to get back up the ice. Davis with it, coming across the blue line, but Ward having to get down on the ice to drag his skate and prevent that offside call. Alberts out of his net, can't get to it. Hay with it behind his own goal. In front of him, he's got Meraz, and on the near side, he's got Star. Coming out of the bench is Dragonick. That one ahead to Star. They're going to call that offside with 45 seconds to go. 55 seconds left on Watney's roughing minor. Hicks has it. Tried to pick it up going parallel to the blue line, but couldn't come away with it. Wisely dumps it in. Hay behind his own net. He's going to hold it. Come around the right side of the net. Push it ahead to his own man on the far wall. Now back to Hay at his own, at a faceoff circle in his own zone. Now Murdoch picks it up. He's going to push it ahead to Hicks. Hicks with some speed down the far side. He's got two men in front of him. Cutting to the center is Johnson. He gets it to Johnson. Johnson can't get a stick to it. Peach there almost trying to get to it as well. And now heading the other way is Meraz. Mraz has Peach behind him, two gold jerseys in front of him, and he's put into the wall on the far side with less than 10 seconds to go. And that is likely going to do it for this period. And it is. There's the buzzer for the first period of action. Kyle Watney skating out of the penalty box. He'll have 8 seconds to go when we rejoin these two teams at the beginning of the second period. 19 shots for the Vandals, 14 for the Vikings so far. In this first period, a lot more even than what we've seen so far in this tournament, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, they were. You can tell right now the game, they're evenly matched. There's no question about that. But I am going to find it interesting. We're going to try to track this down for people. But I want to see if Albert's got any assists this year as a goaltender, because as much as he's out and as much as he's trying to make plays, it'll be interesting to see if he has any points this year.
All right, we'll take a look at that. And we will be back with the second period of action in this third-place contest for the 2017 NPHC Conference Tournament presented by Barrelhouse Pub and Pizza, live from Cheney, Washington, and the Eastern Washington University Recreation Center. Taking a look back at the score sheet, no goals, 5 total penalties, the first one on Ward of Portland State, and then 4 straight power play opportunities for Portland State, as Idaho went to the box 4 straight times. And like I said, we'll have that 8-second layover for Kyle Watney's penalty as we head back into the locker rooms. Step away for just a moment, and we will be back with the second period of action live from Cheney, Washington. Stick around. I think this one's going to get good. And welcome back to Eastern Washington University and the Eastern Washington University Recreation Center about to get underway for the second period of the 2017 NPHC Conference Tournament presented by Barrelhouse Pizza. Third place game. University of Idaho in gold uniforms moving from right to left. The Portland State University Vikings in green, black, and white uniforms moving left to right. My name's Tyler Pisani, and joining me here at the broadcast table, Gary Allen. And what did you think of that first period?
Well, it was very evenly matched. You can see, even look at the shots on goal, 19-14 with the Vandals leading that. But they're very comparable to each other. It had a good flow to the game.
And an interception in the neutral zone. Here comes Hay. I'm sorry, that's not Hay. That is Sure for the Vandals. They started this period 8 seconds on the penalty kill. Watney out of the box already. With it again is Dragonek. He tries to feed it out front. Nobody there. Puck in front of his own bench. Picking it up in the neutral zone now is Moroz.
Out front right now in the slot.
A big shot, just too tall. Diving on his back, Albert still somehow able to keep that out of his net. Laying flat on his back. Idaho just having to get that top shelf, but nobody could get underneath it.
Well, I noticed with Albert, even yesterday, he has a real quick glove hand, and it's going to be real difficult to get one by him on that one. Again, they might go five hole, but he has a very, very quick glove hand.
And a face-off won by the Vikings again. This time back into the neutral zone. And picking it up on the far face-off circle. A big hit there as Sewell just kind of ran into Barnes. Both of their heads kind of bouncing backwards. And in the neutral zone, Davis giving chase. Miller there first, picking it up in front of his own net. Now is Barnes. Surveys the ice, sees a man in the center. Ward can't handle it. Davis does. Miller now. Sewell's got it. It's kind of bouncing all over the place. And now with it is Moroz. He's got it out front to his own man. That's Ward. Ward tries to get a shot. Can't get any power behind it. Moroz with it now in the corner. Knocked off the puck by Miller. Pushed out front now to Ward. And now here come the Vandals. They've got a 4-on-2 opportunity if they want it. Slowed down in a shot by Danger right into the chest of a Vikings player. So that one not even going to count as a shot on goal. Miller has it now on the far side. An interception by Smith. A shot and a goal. How did he do that?
I think he caught Warren not really thinking that he was going to get to the puck. I think he was thought it was going to float by him. And he got a stick on it, and it definitely surprised Warren on that one.
And that was a good defensive play by the Vandals up until somehow he got that shot off. The captain, Jason Smith, I believe is who scored that one.
Now I'm wondering, is that Warren in net, or do they put Grover back in?
I believe that is Warren. Our score sheet says one thing. Our lineup sheet says one thing, but I believe the numbers they have backwards.
Well, I'm looking at the size of the two net miners.
They pulled a quick one?
I'm not sure. But I noticed that yesterday that had a similarity of a couple shots that I know Grover wanted back yesterday, and it looked similar to that, but I may be wrong.
Well, and actually on my score sheet it says that their numbers are backwards, so that is actually Grover. I'm getting that from the scorers table that they switched goaltenders after submitting the score sheet. So that, in fact, is Grover in net today.
And that's a definite interesting move because Warren was having an outstanding game. Again, Grover played great yesterday, but that just had a similarity of a couple of goals that went in yesterday that were real nonchalant to it, surprised him. Well, we'll see how Idaho bounce back on this one. Because right now, they don't seem to skip a beat, so the goal didn't seem like it interrupted their play any, or they're focusing on that.
No, and we are Portland State back on a power play as Smith scored that goal, and then Miller is now in the box for the Vandals. And coming out of his net again is Alberts, something we've become accustomed to seeing here so far in this tournament. A shot there kicked away off of the bottom iron, in fact. Now Barnes, he's going to feed it down low, back to Barnes at the near side point. Kicked away. Dangerous puck out front for the Vandals. Fired a shot by Ward, and then he was taken down by Hicks afterwards. Ward's looking for a man out front. He's got two of them. Looks like he's going to go all the way back up to the blue line. Shot fired by Hay. Deflected over to Ward in the corner. Ward mishandles it, and it's sent the length of the ice with 20 seconds remaining on Miller's penalty. 16:15 to go here in this period. A shot, too much ice on that one, not enough puck. And sure. Moan sends it ahead, and quickly covering it up as Alberts. He's going to give his team a chance to take a breather.
Well, it's interesting watching Grover, and I like his game a lot, and it seems the more difficult the shot is, the better he performs. And just every once in a while, it seems like he goes in a little lapse, and that's where they get an easy goal. Just looking at that last flurry, he was stopping everything that was shooting on him. There were some difficult shots.
And a delayed penalty coming against Portland State. As Miller's penalty expired, Grover skating all the way down the ice now to get back on the bench. And that will be a delayed call, a hooking minor against Portland State.
Is that star going in the box?
That I believe it is. So Star gonna take a break, sit down for just a moment with 4:26 gone in this period. It'll be Star, 2 minutes for hooking.
If I was Portland State's coach, you can accept that because Star plays a really good game. He just every once in a while gets himself in a bind and takes a penalty that's questionable, but he's a good hockey player. You can accept that.
And out of his goal now is Grover. Picking it up on the far side is Moroz. Johnson feeds it ahead. Back into the neutral zone where Hay picks it up. Hay's going to go across the ice and sent all the way down. And Grover comes out to get it. Now Miller with it. Miller still pushes it ahead to Hicks. Now coming away with it is Johnson, and they're going to call that offside as Kenning came into the zone just a couple of seconds early.
Definitely on this power play, Idaho's having some difficulty setting up and figuring out what they want to do when they go in the attack zone.
Now pushed ahead, coming away with it is Peach. Peach across the Eagles, painted on the ice. Watney taps it ahead to his own man, crashing on the far side. A good save by Alberts as Pierce tried to poke that one home. Another opportunity there. Pierce has it. He gives it up to Watney. Watney is going to go near side to Moan. Moan looks for an easy shot. More placement than power there. Another opportunity turned away by Alberts as Hayes got it. I'm sorry, that's Sure now. Picking it up is Pierce. He tried to sneak it inside the near post. A couple of rebounds and just a little bit too tall. Pierce still has it right out front. He had Sure knocked down from behind, looking for the penalty, not going to get it. 10 seconds remaining on this power play.
Idaho's doing a lot better job on their power play chances. They're setting up in the zone really well. There looks like a trip, and it is.
And that's going to be a trip. So as Portland State gets an extra man on the ice, they're only going to have it for a moment. Players all over the place, and that was a huge hit from behind as Peach is still down on the ice.
And there may be a couple extra minutes on that one, because that was definitely a hard hit from behind. It'll be interesting to see what the referee does.
And Ward was the original player going to the box, so we'll see what they call on him extra, if anything, because you're right, that was a little bit harder than necessary, I would say.
Well, the problem was he was taking his frustrations out because he had the initial penalty called on him, and it didn't make sense what he was attempting to do at the end.
Yeah, and you can see the officials. Well, we can see the officials in the scorer's crease trying to discuss it.
I'll be real surprised if he doesn't get an extra two tacked on to that.
At least I would almost think that might be a two and a five. But at this point, it's just pure speculation. Look at you. The experience pays off.
Well, I was kind of almost leaning on he might get a 10 because that was pretty blatant what he did. And it was right in front of the referee, so I'm really not sure what he was thinking on that particular play.
So now Portland State going to be down a man for 4 minutes. This is Idaho's chance to get back into this game, down by one with 13:15 to go here in this second period. Murdoch has it back across his own line. Feeds it ahead all the way to the top side to Kenning. Kenning, a weak backhand to the center. Alberts clears it all the way down the ice. A good clearance by the goaltender for Portland State. Idaho taking their time here, knowing that they have 4 minutes with the man advantage. Johnson now across the Portland State line. He's got Hicks in the middle. Murdoch behind him. On the far side, Kenning calling for it. He's going to go all the way up top to Peach. Peach thinks about it. Now to Murdoch. Murdoch fires it out front. He has a man there in Kenning looking to deflect it. Now back up to Peach. Peach right into the center to Hicks. Hicks to Murdoch. Murdoch off of the skates of a jumping Dragonic. Now Kenning has it. Kenning's got Hicks out front. Surveys the ice off of the near wall to Murdoch. Murdoch takes it off the bounce. Backhands it to Johnson in the center. 2:50 to go on this power play. 12 minutes left in the period. Murdoch now just ahead to Kenning. Kenning a light touch to Hicks. Hicks has his pocket picked from behind by Dragonic, but able to keep it in as Murdoch. Now on the far side is Johnson. Johnson along the wall. Murdoch's going to pick it up right in front of us. Murdoch down low to Kenning. Back up to Peach. Peach to Kenning. Kenning tries to feed it across to Hicks, hits players' legs in the middle, and that's going to give Portland State a chance to breathe. But this much attacking time on a power play, that's got to be hard for a team that's got a short bench.
It's very difficult. And what I like what Kenning was doing in that whole shift that he was on, he was doing one-time passes. They were extremely accurate. They got some nice shots off of it.
And now picking it up in the neutral zone is Peach. He's going to come across the blue line. He's looking all the way across. Just a nice, easy touch to Sure. Opportunity there by Peach. He loses a stick. Sure has it now. Up top to Watney. Watney winds up, fires a shot wide of the net, but the rebound is there for Sure. Albert's not afraid to come out of his net and dive on top of it. 1:37 to go on this double minor for Tanner Ward.
I'll tell you one thing, Sure has a laser of a shot. He unloaded on two of those right there. And again, Albert did a good job of blocking him, but man, he has a hard shot.
Peach now thinks about the shot, decides not to, gives it back to Watney. Watney fires a shot, deflected just wide of the net. On the far side, it's Murdoch. Murdoch, a shot too tall, but right into the chest of several players. Portland State again doing a good job clearing it down the ice.
Well, Idaho's power play has definitely looked better this go around than previous ones. They're setting up really well in the zone.
Now some pushing and shoving as Pierce gets into the zone. Watney's going to keep it in on the near side. Just 1 minute remaining on this double minor for Tanner Ward. Idaho getting a decent amount of shots, but nothing too much now. And now Grover coming out of his goal. Picking it up is Murdoch. Now with it is Peach. Circles back behind his own net. And they're looking for another rush with 30 seconds left on the penalty. That's Kenning. Kenning, a big shot by Murdoch all the way up into the rafters. And the puck bounces back out onto the ice.
That's one interesting difference between the two goalies from Idaho. Grover is definitely like Alberts. He sure likes to come out of his crease and taste some risk. It's interesting. I don't know if the goalies are to decide on who's going to have the most assist if they can try it, but they both play similar games.
If you can be a part of helping your team win in more way than one, a good opportunity, and Hicks pokes it home. 16 seconds remaining on the power play, and the University of Idaho has tied this one up with 9:39 to go in the second period. This third-place game has gotten very interesting, a very close game. Two goals, one for each team so far in this period.
And I noticed Hicks was talking to a couple Portland State players, letting them know that he definitely scored the goal and what he thought about it. And it was interesting because I don't know if Hayes really appreciated it that much, but it'll be interesting if anything transpires off of that.
And that goal by Hicks, a power play goal, as there was just 16 seconds left on that double minor that Ward received. And that just goes to show you how important it is to stay out of the box and how bad that extra 2 minutes can come back to hurt your team.
Oh, yeah, that definitely cost him that goal on that one. And, again, there was no reason for it. He was already called, take your penalty, and move on.
Now Portland State just trying to get it out of their zone. Some big hits. Picking it up is Smith, Jordan Smith for the Vandals. Now with it is Miller. He sees a man in the center of the neutral zone. Players getting on and off the ice. And two Vandals players wisely leave that puck alone as they were trying to get fresh legs on the ice. Could have been too many men there. The officials say that since they left it alone, no harm, no foul.
Well, one thing I've noticed, Idaho is stepping up their offensive game because now the shot differential is growing. It's 31 for our Idaho and 15 for Portland State. And it reminds me of yesterday's game. Idaho is starting to put up more offensive pressure on the opposing team.
Well, and they really came alive in the second half of yesterday's game. Really made it a game between them and Portland. We're down by four goals at one point, or three goals at two different points, and then came back to pull it within one late in the game.
No, they definitely let Western know they were there to play yesterday. They did a nice job.
Miller has it. He's going to bring it up the near side, and a huge hit from Miller on Smith. Smith breaking his stick, and now it's Hay trying to get back at Miller. They're trying to figure out what the call is.
There's a couple Portland State players that were letting Miller know that they did not appreciate that hit.
Well, and they're calling a penalty. I don't believe that it's on Miller.
Well, it is. That's interesting. Because Miller was the one that hit it.
They're
going to
say a high stick from... We'll find out who in just a second. Definitely a penalty called.
Yeah.
But,
well, that's definitely going to Portland
State. Jason Smith is not happy at all. They're saying that on that hit, he hit Miller in the head with his stick. They're going to give him, in addition to being absolutely leveled, they're going to make him sit for 2 minutes. Has nothing to do with the concussion protocol. He's going to sit 2 minutes for a high stick.
In addition to insult to injury, he broke his stick on that too. That was a big hit.
Yeah, that was a rough couple of seconds there for Jason
Smith.
Now
it's getting a little bit chippy out here now. There's a lot more pushing and shoving after whistles. I think they're starting to feel the pressure right now with a 1-1 game and over halfway done in this period, but I'm seeing more and more of that after the play is over.
And in this league, if you fight, it's an automatic ejection. And Portland State cannot afford to go down another man with only four additional skaters on the bench. Right now, only three because one of them's in the box. So I guess they only have three additional skaters total. Me working on my math skills here live on air. With it is Mraz. He's going to send it down the ice with 1:30 remaining on the penalty. 7:45 left to go in the second period. Peach is going to bring it up the near side. Going to take it to the far side now. Thinking about the shot, decides not to. Lays it off for his own man in front of his own bench. Now on the far side, Watney cutting to the middle.
Okay, Watney and Hayes are just going at it. They've been going up, but now we got, I think, a star that jumped in on this. But they were battling.
That got taken down. That was Ryan Schur. Got in a little bit too close to the goaltender is what Star was mad about. Watney now going to the box. That's the end of that penalty. Maybe.
Watney,
of that power play.
Like I said, Watney and Hayes were just hammering on each other in front of the net, and the referees were letting it go, and they skated away, and then they came right back and started to hit on each other again. That created that little skirmish.
So these penalties coming at 12:29. It'll be Watney and Star. I think Watney's putting himself in the box at the moment.
Well, he's going to go. There's no question about that. And now they're debating on whose fault was who. As I'm looking at the penalty box, they're both chirping at each other right now.
And something in this building, the penalty boxes are, for the most part, open from one side to the other. But they do have some dividing glass that goes about three-quarters of the way back. But there's essentially a back hallway in that official's box. There's actually a back hallway, and it looks like Star sent to the locker room, maybe. Or not. We'll find out what's going on here. Are they not going to give him a penalty?
Well, but that's interesting.
Well, they told it looks like they're not.
They told him to come out. I haven't seen that before.
Okay.
Because he was comfortable sitting there. I mean, he thought he was going to get it. So that'll be
apparently the assistant captain for Portland State arguing his case fairly well, saying that he was just coming in to protect his own man.
Well, I suppose that headlock you can consider coming in and protecting his own guy. I mean, that's an interesting. I've not seen a player do that. Sit in the box, was ready, had his helmet off, then referee told him to get out. So
okay, well. An interesting turn of events here as now we'll have some 4-on-4 hockey for a minute 10. 7:31 to go here in this second period. As almost a 4-on-3.
Well, it's interesting just watching Star. I think he's still surprised that he's not. Now they opened up the box, so I don't know if he's going back in now.
Portland State's coach getting some confirmation, I guess, or some clear.
But it was kind of funny watching Star skating because he looked cheap. Now we got Rose is going in the box. I had a feeling Portland State was going to get a penalty. I think they're not sure who they were going to call it on, but because they both were going at it pretty hard.
So they put Mraz in the box.
Let Star out of the box.
There's another player in the Idaho box. So we got penalties all over the place here in Cheney, Washington. We'll find out who that is. That's number 15 for Idaho. So Ryan Schur, the one that actually got drugged down from behind, him and Mraz are both going to sit for coincidental minors.
I wonder if someone got an unsportsmanlike.
So there's some clarification from the scorers table. Schur and Mraz, both a two-minute misconduct and a goal for the University of Idaho. What a move to pull Alberts to one side and then tuck it home.
I think it's Smith that got that. He did a nice deke, went to his right, and Alberts is already moving toward his.
That goal coming 13:07 of this period. So as we were, and that's not good now, as Jason Smith was just sitting in the box, in the penalty box, and now all of a sudden can't skate.
It definitely looked like an ankle, because he's not moving.
And I don't know if he got mad in the box and injured himself, because he's been in the box for 37 seconds, I'm sorry, for almost 2 minutes of game time.
That's definitely not helping Portland State's cause.
No, and now they're going to put Tanner Ward in there to serve out the rest of that penalty. They have one player on their bench now. But real quick, clarification, Schurer and Meraz, both two-minute roughing minors with a 10-minute misconduct attached. Watney going to serve out a two-minute roughing, and then he'll be back out on the ice. But the big story here, the captain for Portland State heading to the locker room after sitting in the box for almost 2 minutes. I don't know if the pain just got to be too much for him on an ankle or what happened there. We'll see if we can get some information here at the intermission.
But he was definitely not putting any weight on it. He definitely had assistance going off the ice.
So that is a storyline that we will continue to follow in this one. But right now, Idaho just pulled ahead 2-1 with 6:20 to go here in this period.
Alberts is really going to have to stand big now. And he's having a great game, but they are shorthanded, Portland State.
And this is, if he wants to get an assist, this may be his time. He may have to skate up to center ice to do it. But
to be frank with you, the way he comes out of that net, I wouldn't be real surprised to see him.
And Ward is back out onto the ice. He finished the final 23 seconds. And a good chance there by Portland State as a Vandal dropped his stick. And Davis took advantage of that. Still trying to figure out exactly what happened there. So, and clarification on that last Idaho goal, that was Keel Kenning. Now Portland State moving the puck well. Ward, he gives it back, or he gets it back from right out front, a shot, and Grover snatches that out of the air. 5:26 to go here in the second period.
Actually, the game had a really nice flow to it until that last scrum that all of a sudden people were getting in the penalty box, getting back out of the penalty box, and now it's kind of getting a little choppy, but it had a nice flow to it.
And then apparently somebody getting injured in the penalty box, as we saw Jason Smith, after serving a minute 37 of his penalty, then go to the locker room. They're currently calling that just a lower body injury. He may return.
But that was interesting, watching the star go in the box to come back out of the box. And I know he was surprised. You could just tell by his body language. He was waiting for him to call him back in.
And now some fighting for it down in the corner. Coming away with it is Davis. That's going to get pushed ahead. A big shot deflected away. Now picking it up for the Vandals is Sewell. Sewell wide of the net, 4:40 to go here in the first period. Giving chase is Davis. Davis trying to send it down the ice. Two players in the box currently, one for each team, both serving out 10-minute misconducts. And this one definitely hurts Portland State more, as they've got one player on the bench. They're just looking to survive for the next 4.5 minutes. And hopefully get into the locker room and get themselves a breather. Down by one, though, that's not going to be easy. Coming up the ice with it now is Ward. Ward has a man in the center. Ward obliterated by Miller.
Miller has a nice all-around game. He can go offensive, he can go defensive. He definitely likes to hit people. There's no question about that.
And that's something you kind of become accustomed to seeing from a big man, is them laying off some big hits. And
he does that a lot.
Dragonick there. Firing a shot right at Miller, letting him know his disapproval of the way that he's treating his teammates.
And I think Miller just told him he thought it was a nice hit. So, but I'll tell you, Miller has one heavy, hard shot, and it is a rocket.
So we'll bring that back down to the other side of the ice. 3 minutes, 46 seconds to go here in the second period in Cheney, Washington. The University of Idaho leading Portland State University.
Oh, nice shot.
By a score of 3-1 now. Just as I'm recapping, here comes the University of Idaho. You can hear the fans here in the building.
I think it was Moen that got this, the goal. He went top shelf. Nice shot.
I think you are correct.
In Albert's defense, he was semi-screen, but that had eyes. That puck had eyes. That was right under the crossbar.
And it looks like Idaho going to take a timeout here. Or, I'm sorry, Portland State going to take a timeout here.
Portland State taking a timeout to take a breather. They only with one guy on
Absolutely.
The bench. It's a lot of ice time for the five players.
And we're going to step aside here for just a moment. And the player is being called back out into the center of the ice.
I think what you're seeing right now is Idaho's really putting the pressure on the offensive zone. I think their goal is to tire out Portland State. And so it'll be interesting if they keep putting the pressure on them.
Well, and here we have another puck drop. This time Idaho coming away with it. And Portland State is really in a bad way now as they're down by two. That was a good call by you, Moen, with the third goal for the University of Idaho. Now up 3-1 on Portland State. The Vikings just need to survive another 3 minutes, 15 seconds. Now a chance on a breakaway for Starr. He's got to get around Peach. He's got a man crashing in the middle in Draganovic.
Well, I think he's been out the whole game. I don't know if he's been to the bench yet.
Well, with only one guy there, everybody's going to be taking a lot longer shifts now. The two players currently in there serving out their 10-minute misconducts. They'll come back in with just over 30 seconds left in this period, which is about 2 minutes from now, as we've got 2:36 remaining on the clock for the second period of the inaugural NPHC Conference Tournament third place game presented by Barrelhouse Pub and Pizza. Tyler Pisani, Gary Allen with you live from the Eastern Washington University Recreation Center. The Eagles hosting this inaugural tournament. And so far, I'd say the turnout's been pretty good and the gameplay has been too.
And that was interesting, Tyler, because I was just thinking the same thing. I've been impressed with the tournament. I like the format of it. It's been run really well. And hopefully they continue this because I like the whole atmosphere of this, and actually there's a good crowd here for the third and fourth place game, and it's been well done.
And the University of Idaho travels well. They've got their fans here just coming from about an hour and a half down the road. Portland State fans, they traveled here as well, coming from quite a bit further away.
Well, someone's going in the box.
A big hit in the corner, and we'll find out who it is. Idaho touching up the puck. They're going to be down a man now as well. This penalty coming.
Looks like they're going to get him on a slash, but I'm not sure who yet.
This penalty coming. 17.
Could be Munn.
52. That one a slash. Jordan Smith for the Vandals. Number 21. He's going to sit for the rest of this period, essentially, unless Portland State can find the back of the net.
But there's no question Idaho is definitely taking advantage of a bigger bench offensively, because right now a 39-18 shot differential, they're definitely taking full advantage of having more players.
For sure. And that's showing, especially here late in this second period.
But you got to give Portland State credit. There's no quit in this team, and I'm extremely surprised. They're playing their game. It's just, I think it's catching up to them.
Well, and with a minute and a half left, they need to go all out for the next 90 seconds to try to get one more before they head into the locker room. Picking it up now is Starr. Tried to send it across the ice to Dragunovic, but getting his stick to it was Hay, disrupting the pass between his own teammates. Idaho seems very content with holding out of the puck. And you saw Alberts there waving off his teammate. Go down the ice. Let me pass it to you.
Yeah, there's no question about that. I thought that was kind of funny. He just waved him off, and he went around his own net.
And a bad turnover now in the neutral zone. Johnson takes a shot. Alberts lets it go for his own player. Now pushes it ahead. Portland State having a hard time getting to these passes now. Not that they're bad passes, but you can tell that their legs are getting tired. Now Portland State surveying. Man right in the middle, knocked off of the puck by Murdoch, giving chase in the center of Starr. He's got Ward in front of the goal. And Starr just leveled by Miller. Miller, a one-man wrecking crew out there tonight. A good deflection attempt there by Starr, back up after that hit from Miller.
He just buried him, and I don't think Starr appreciated it, but that was a clean hit. It was like needs to keep his head up. Man, Miller just rocked him.
Well, and that's the second or third time that Miller's just gotten a hold of him. Four goals so far in this period. Portland State hoping to make it five and get their second before they head to the locker rooms. Especially with their captain sitting in that room with an injury. We'll see if he comes back out for the third period. And back to five-a-side hockey with 5 seconds left on the clock. A swing and a miss and a bad turnover. Albert's coming all the way out. He's got to stand back up. Bear takes a shot and just barely saved by the buzzer is Albert's. He got out there and disrupted that just enough.
It had to be no more than 0.2 seconds. Albert's did a nice job of poke checking it away, but he poke checked the right to the Idaho player. But I tell you, I'm still going to try to look up on Albers. I know he's got to have a couple of assists this year. This guy, I'm not seeing a goalie play offensive hockey like he has and trying to be a playmaker.
No, he's doing a very good job of making sure that his teammates can get back down the ice quickly. And again, as we head into this third period, it's something we're going to have to see even more because this team is very shorthanded, just one player on the bench. And we'll have to see how that goes here in the third period. But taking a look back at the second period, four different goals. Portland State actually opened up the scoring, getting their first goal scored by Jason Smith, their captain, who now is in the locker room. Idaho getting their first goal on a power play after Tanner Ward sat in the box for a double minor. Just 16 seconds left on that penalty when Hicks was able to find the back of the net. And then goal after goal after goal. And here we are at a second intermission score of 3-1 in favor of the Vandals. We'll step aside and come back as we wrap up this third place game of the 2017 NPHC Conference Tournament presented by Barrelhouse Pub and Pizza. Hopefully I can go find some pizza during this intermission. We'll be back. Keep it right here. You're watching the tournament on YouTube.